So, like we are saying, transaction five, the company provided service on account for $3,000. Now, watch this. Because the company provided service on account, the company did not receive cash, like we said. Accounts receivable is one type of asset. We record money owed to the company in a bucket called accounts receivable. So if you take a look at the company's report and you see $20 million in accounts receivable, that is what they are expecting to receive from various customers in the future. So here, our accounts receivable went up because we did not receive cash. So we record it for 3,000 as an asset. Now, on the right side, we also have it recorded as $3,000 under service revenue. Now, I want you to pay. Here is the next transaction. Of course, as you know, we have to spend money to make money. Here, the company spent $3,200 in cash expenses. $2,000 was for rent, $1,200 for employee salaries. So clearly, cash went down by $3,200. And look at on the left side of the equation, expenses, rent expense, salaries expense, minus 2,000, minus 1,200. Why is it a negative? Recall that we said that expenses decrease equity while revenue increases equity. So we have plus under revenue, minus under expense being negative. So what do we have here? We have negative 3,200 on the left side, we have negative 32 on the right side, so the accounting equation is in balance. So let's take a look at payment on accounts payable. Here is one thing a lot of students get confused about. Recall, we bought $500 worth of office supplies on credit on account, we didn't pay. So on one hand, then we have supplies. That was an asset went up. Then our obligations or accounts payable or debt also went up. So the account equation was in balance. But take a look at what is happening here. Now we are not paying part of what we owe the vendor, $300. So clearly, cash went down by $300. Now, supplies is no longer applicable here because we are paying off some of our obligations. So $300 is deducted from accounts payable. Okay, again, remember, accounts payable, that is the bucket of the account that we use to keep track of our obligations or our oral promise to pay. While accounts receivable is the opposite. Receivable, what we are going to receive from the customers in the future. Now, let's take a look at the transaction eight. Transaction eight is very confusing to students. Here, collection on accounts. A lot of students confuse this as revenue. This is not revenue. Revenue has been provided on account. Here, the customer is paying us for what the customer owes us. So if the customer is paying us cash, clearly we are receiving cash. So cash goes up by 2,000. Our receivable, the amount of money that we are likely to receive from the customers in the future, goes down. We are not going to receive that much again from the customer. They are not paying some of their promise to pay, so accounts receivable goes down. A lot of students will confuse these $2,000 as revenue. It is not revenue. Customers are just paying what they owe after we provide their service on account. Payment of cash dividends. Remember we talked about dividends? Here, you are paying dividend, $5,000 reduces cash. And of course, dividend is one of the children of equity. Dividend services are all, I consider them as children of equity. Equity is very involved. And equity also goes down by 5,000. Why negative? Because like we said, dividends are decreased equity. So moving along, that is transaction nine. So believe it or not, we are almost done. So that is the conclusion of recording all the transactions by using what? The accounting equation layout or format. Okay, so let's take a look at this. You see how beautiful this is? Or some of you will say this is extremely busy. Now, what we did here, I want you to note, is systematically we recorded every transaction, and by the time we were done recording all the transactions systematically, as we discussed, we verified the accuracy or the mathematical accuracy of our work. As you can see, the left side of the accounting equation is 30,500, and the right side is also 30,500, so the accounting equation is in balance. So now, the question is, why all of this? Why all of this? So, at this point in time, we need to go ahead and take a look at the significance of these transactions that we analyzed and recorded. Now, as the accountant, none of this means anything to your boss or to the owner of your company. Let's assume that your uncle that you are living with started the corporation, and your uncle realized that you are studying and you are accounting. And your uncle said, you know what, I've been operating this business for a month. I really don't know where I'm going. I don't know whether I'm making money or not. Can you please help me out? So you decided to take on the task, and you decided to record all these transactions systematically as we discussed. Why? The purpose of this exercise is for you to produce meaningful report, or what we call financial statements in business world, so that your uncle will be in a position to determine how well the company is doing and the financial condition of the company. So what we are going to do now is to prepare financial statements. In English, we say financial report. Accounting, we say financial statements. Now, this financial statement consists of valuable information that we use to make your business decisions. Now, take a look at the four main financial statements: income statement, statement of retained earnings, balance sheet, and statement of cash flows. Let's quickly go through each of them. Here, we say financial statements are business documents. I don't know whether we should call them documents, but they are reports that are used to communicate information for decision makers. Like we said, here are the four main financial statements or reports. Now, let's take a look at the first report, which is income statement. This report, I want you to take a note. Simply, but first of all, it is important for you to know that each financial statement talks about different story. And decision makers need all the financial statements before they make a decision, because the story embedded in one financial statement is not in the other financial statement. Suffice it to say, this is the number one income statement. We said that this is a report or a statement of that shows the profitability or the performance of a company within a period of time. What are we talking about here? How well did the company do this month, this quarter, this year? If you want to know that, you look at the income statement. The income statement consists of only two things. Number one, revenue, expenses. How much the company made, how much the company spent, all right? And the difference, we call it what? Net income. If revenues exceed expenses, if the opposite is the case, we call it net loss. Now, it is also important for you to understand the heading. The heading is very important. Three line items. Remember them with the two W's. Who are you preparing the financial statement for? What type of financial statement are you preparing? In this case, income statement. When? And that is the time. And look at how it is dated. Month ended. In other words, for that month, ended November 30, 2016. So here you have it with the income statement. Let's take a look at the other statement. Statement of retained earnings. The statement of retained earnings simply reports how much profit or how much net income or how much earnings the company decided to keep and not give to the owners. Remember now, the net income belongs to the owners of the company. But if they give the owner some, we call it dividend. Whatever is left, we call it rich earnings. So at the beginning of the month, it was zero because this is a brand new company. During the month, the company generated $5,300 in net income. Now guess what? The company gave the owner $5,000 of the $5,300. That $5,000, remember, we call it what? Dividends. And the difference, the balance of $300 is return earnings. Now, of course, take a look at the title, so on and so forth. Now, let's take a look at the next financial statement. We call this the balance sheet. Now, this report of financial statements talks about the financial condition or the financial position of a company at a point in time. What does that mean? That simply means this financial statement does not talk about the situation within a period of time, but it talks about a snapshot, exactly what is the financial condition right now. A very good way of understanding the balance sheet is taking a look at your balance sheet as an individual. We have three elements. It doesn't matter whose balance sheet we are looking at. In this case, when we prepare the balance sheet for individual like you and I, I'm not talking about the company's balance sheet, we don't call the third element stockholders' equity. We call it net worth. So look at this real quick. If your total assets, I'm talking about you now personally, if your total assets is $1.5 million and you owe people $0.3 million, the difference between all your assets and what you owe people will be what? $1.2 million. So we said that your net worth is $1.2 million. So that is how we know your financial condition. The same is true for a corporation. In this case, look at, for this corporation, total assets is $30,500. The liability, debt is $200. And the difference between $30,500 and $200 is $30,300. And then these two combined will give you $30,500, primarily from the accounting equation that we prepared. Now, listen, you need to catch this. Preparing this financial statement is a piece of cake after we have systematically recorded all these transactions. So basically what we are doing here is we are transferring the information in here and we are using the information in here to prepare the financial statement. In this case, income statement, statement of retained earnings, and the balance sheet. Folks, listen. This is the meat. This is the nucleus of the matter. This is the most important thing that we do. So look at this. Your uncle, like I said, this stuff right here, your uncle or the owner of the company don't care about this business. A summary of this makes sense to the owner of the company. So by the time you are done preparing the first statement, which is income statement, look at this. Your uncle will take a look at the one page, one piece of paper, and say, whoa, I generated $8,500 in revenue and my expenses $3,200. The difference of $5,300 is my net income, or what we used to call net profit, okay? So this is information. And then your uncle also take a look at a statement of retained earnings in order for him to know exactly how much of the profit was retained in the business. Now, of course, the balance sheet, it also talks about the financial condition or the financial position of the company. And I demonstrated that by using a personal person's a balance sheet. Then, of course, you have the statement of cash flows. Don't worry about this. We are going to talk about this in your upper level accounting course. Now, we are almost done. Remember, at the beginning I said that our objective is threefold. Number one, we need to understand accounting rules, how to apply them. Number two, our understanding and application of accounting rules help us to prepare information for different constituencies to use for different decision making. Then number three, we also need to analyze the information. In other words, what do the numbers actually mean?